Maxi, welcome to Tisbury Tent.
How very kind. It's nice to be here.
It's lovely to have you here. Very excited about this today. Now, you guys obviously are very used to doing festivals like the Wireless Festival. What is it that keeps bringing you back?
It's a buzz. It's a serious buzz, and I particularly like, people ask, do I like the big gigs and the small gig, or the small gigs? And the small gigs are fantastic because of the intimacy and the atmosphere.
Yeah.
It's
we'll love this
really
then.
Easy to build up, say, in a place like this. But the big festivals are also really mind-blowing, because you know for a fact that maybe 5% of the audience have come to see you.
Yeah.
You know, if you're lucky.
Yeah.
So that means if you get that crowd rocking from front to back, you've definitely made new friends that day. And so that's very exciting.
Yeah, and you always do, every...
It's amazing, I have no idea why. But it's really great that it happens. It's we have quite a lot of people coming up and say, oh yeah, I'm into punk music. I saw you at Glastonbury, you were brilliant.
Yeah.
All these people tend to like all kinds of different things, tend to like what we do on stage, which is great.
So you were, I was actually here at Hyde Park on the Live 8, and you were in, were you, it was
we
Berlin,
were in Berlin, yeah.
Right, and I
running
remember
about
you watched
six
you on
hours
the screen,
late.
And I was like, I wish I was there, like the best act out of the whole Live 8,
that's,
I thought, personally.
That's very kind of you to say, but it's really an odd gig, because it's the biggest gig we've ever played. There were 300,000 people, it was like enormous, but they were all on this long road that you absolutely couldn't see the end of. And our on-stage sound was pants. And we have some machines that will kick in with some beats, because the poor drummer's only got one pair of hands and legs. And we couldn't hear any of them.
God.
No, none at all. So we kind of figured, it's a complete disaster. Nothing's gone right, but let's just go for it anyway.
No, it was
brilliant. Then when we finished, it turned out that what we were hearing on stage was not what everybody out front was getting, everything that they required. So, like,
so are you working on any new material at the moment?
We are, actually. We put an album out on November the 28th to all new arrivals.
Yeah, which I have at home.
Good girl.
Yay.
And yes, we are. We're going to be doing some stuff, but on a nice sort of relaxed sort of a level, rather than it must be finished by September, because
right.
that's what we did last time.
Yeah.
And it wasn't much fun.
Right.
So we're going to take our time and do it next time.
And how do you keep coming up with so much new material? Because every track that you do is so obviously faithless, but it's so different from track to track.
I think it's because of the chemistry that we have together as a group, but also because, if you like, the biggest topic of conversation within the band and in the songs is other people.
Right.
You know, if other people is your thing, then there's never anything. There's never a halt, you know. There's always stuff to write about. People are the most fascinating things out here.
Yeah.
And so if that's what you're into, then it's a never-ending well of stuff to dive into that's interesting for everybody.
Yeah. Do you find it hard to take the music that you've written and produced in the studio? Is it hard or easy to take it onto a festival stage?
It can be really difficult. It can be. They're two completely separate areas, because with an album, you want the album to still be being played 100 years after you're dead. So you put layers and layers and layers of stuff in there that people won't actually, might not even get until they've had the album 2 or 3 years. They've got records that, oh, I've never heard that before. But with the live set, you just want to strip everything back, strip it all down to, so that the song is at its rawest. You just then deliver that raw emotion as powerfully as you can. So they're two utterly separate things. So things that work on record sometimes absolutely do not work on stage.
Right.
And you have to rework it for the stage to make it more powerful or more sad or more poignant or whatever it is. Because on stage, it's only the one time.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then it's over.
Yeah.
Rather than with an album, you can rewind it, rewind it, rewind it. So.